Hi everyone, welcome to Study of Science, myself Ramya. Students, in the previous session, you all have understood about the nervous system and their classifications, correct? So in this session now, firstly, I would like to start with the next important system of this lesson that we are going to study about in briefly, and I will move ahead with another concept. Okay, before that, I would like to brush up whatever you have learned in the previous session. So we understood that we are going to learn mainly about two systems in this lesson. One is the nervous system, correct? And one more is the endocrine system. So nervous system and endocrine system you are going to learn in this lesson. So under nervous system, you all have understood the categories or the classification. So nervous system can be broadly classified into CNS, then PNS, and ANS, correct? You all know, right? So what is CNS? Correct, it is central nervous system, correct? Now this central nervous system, it consists of, absolutely correct, it is consisting of brain and the spinal cord, right? Then what about PNS? PNS is consists of nerves. So from where does the nerves emerges under the PNS system? I have told you, the nerves from the brain, the nerves from the spinal cord, it emerges, right? Two types of nerves I have mentioned. One is the cranial nerves and the one more is the spinal nerves. So that is what we have understood about the peripheral nervous system. And then the third one was the ANS, which is called as autonomous nervous system, which is not under your control. So that was the thing which we have learned in the previous session. So in this session now, let us understand what is endocrine system. See, the name itself says that endo means inside. Okay, inside. So what has been happening inside under endocrine system? Some chemicals are being released. Under endocrine system, some chemicals are released. Some chemicals are released to coordinate. The chemicals are released to coordinate, okay, with the various system inside the body. So these chemicals are released by one of the things. They are called as the glands. They are called as the glands. So I will tell you in detail about the glands as we move ahead in this lesson. So now probably you may all know that few glands present in your body. That is the thyroid gland, pituitary gland, right? And the exocrine glands. So there are many variety of glands which are present inside our body. So these glands which present inside our body, they help to release some chemicals. So those chemicals will control and coordinate some of the systems inside our body. Okay, that is what exactly happens in the endocrine system. Endocrine system is completely based on the chemicals which are being released by the glands. We are going to understand in detail about this as we go ahead, as I told you. Okay, so now, so we came to know that the two things which we are going to understand in detail in this lesson, that is nervous system and endocrine system. So all the animals, they respond in the environment, okay, with respect to stimulus. Right? So for example, what is the stimulus? I'll just give you example. So let us consider ourselves as also animals, right? We're also animals. So when we suppose touch an hot object, or when we suppose touch a cold object, what exactly we do? You all have an idea, right? Suddenly when we touch a hot object or a cold object, what exactly we do? We suddenly remove or withdraw our hands from that particular region. How does it happen? What is making us to do this? Do you have any idea? What is making us to do this? All these activities are being happen because of the nervous system. It happened because of the nervous system. The nerves which are present inside our body is helping to perform all this activity, and that too in fractions of seconds. We have understood that our nerve cells will help us to detect the things. Whatever happens in our environment, everything will be detected by our nerve cells. Our nerve cells, it contains some specialized tips. That is specialized tips, we call it as receptors. Where is these receptors are found? These receptors are found in the specialized tips of the sensory organs. You know what are sense, which are the sensory organs, right? The eyes, the nose, the ears, the skin, the tongue. All these we call it as the sensory organs. So in the sensory organs, the receptors are found. Okay. So these receptors, they help to receive the messages. They help to receive, for example, see the messages like maybe, for example, the receptors which are found in the nose, they help to detect the smell. The receptors which are present in the tongue, they help to detect the taste. Like that, the receptors which are found in the sensory organs, they help to detect the things, whatever happen in our surrounding. Okay, so our entire nervous system, it consists of nerves. Nerves means it is the neurons. Nervous system is comprises of neurons. Okay, so there are n number of neurons. There are millions of neurons which are present in our nervous system. So now when I say neuron, now let us understand how these neurons will help to receive the message from the external environment and sends it to different part of the body. Okay, so now I will draw the diagram of the neuron. I just draw roughly the diagram of neuron. So here are our dendrites. So the neuron consisting of dendrites, and there is nucleus present at the center. We call it as nucleus, which is present in the cell body. And then axon. And this is called as nerve ending. Now first we will label the parts and let us understand in detail about what is the function of the different parts of the neuron. Okay, so this is called as dendrites. They're called as dendrites, and this is the nucleus, and this part is called as the cell body. We call this as axon, and this as the nerve ending. We call it as nerve ending. Okay, so these are some of the different parts which we have labeled in the neuron. So now, how does these different parts which are present in the neuron functions? First of all, what happens? See, for example, when you touch a hot object or when you touch the cold object, what happens? As I told you, the receptors present in the sensory organ will detect. They will detect. They will detect that message, and that message will reach us to the tip of the dendrites. It reaches to the tip of the, that messages will reach us to the tip of the dendrites. This dendrite, they set off the chemical messengers which enter here, and it passes as the electrical impulses. It passes as the electrical impulses. See, the dendrites, it receives the messages from the surrounding. So it sets off the chemical messages and it sends the messages as electrical impulses. From the dendrites, what happened? The dendrites, it receives the messages from the surrounding. From the surrounding, and what does it do? It sends the message to the cell body. Dendrite sends the message to the cell body. What does the cell body do? What does cell body consists of? Cell body consists of the nucleus and other cell organelles like mitochondria, Golgi body. So many things are there, right? They're all called as cell organelles. Okay. So this cell body consists of nucleus. It receives the electrical impulses, and this electrical impulses, now it get travel into the axon. The electrical impulses, it travel along the body, that is along now this axon. The electrical impulses travel, and finally it reaches to the, which region? It reaches to the nerve ending. Now, the electrical impulses which travel from the dendrites to the nerve ending, now what happens as it passes out, this electrical impulses, now again it converts as the chemicals. It converts in as the chemicals. And one more thing you have to understand, dear children, it does not happen with the help of one single neuron. There are, as I told you, millions of neurons are there. So one neuron is getting connected to another neuron. After this neuron, there will be another neuron here. I just draw it in the same color. See, there will be another neuron here. But between one neuron, see, between one neuron to another neuron, there is a space here, right? So what do we call this space as? This space is called as synapse. It is called as synapse. Very important. They will ask in the examination. The space or the gap which is present between one neuron and another neuron, we call it as synapse. Synapse is a gap or the space present between one neuron and another neuron. What happens in between this gap? See, as I told you, the electrical impulses which get traveled from the dendrites to the nerve ending, it just converted into chemicals in this gap. Again, from this region, the chemicals travels to another neuron. Okay, again, the dendrites, it receives the chemicals get set off. Later what happened? It again travel as the electrical impulses. Why electrical impulses? Because you all know that, as I told you, that when we are aware about that we are in danger, what happened? We perform the activity within fractions of seconds, right? So this happens, this activity happens within fractions of second. That means it has to travel, the messages has to be traveled faster, right? From our sensory neurons and from our sensory organs, the messages has to travel to the spinal cord within fractions of seconds. Okay, so that is the reason it travels as the electrical impulses. But when it reaches to another neuron, from one neuron to another neuron, there is a gap. We call it as a synapse. Okay, clear? I hope you all have understood about the neuron. So in the next session, we'll continue with another topic. I hope you all have understood well about the nervous system and endocrine system. In briefly, I told you about nervous system and endocrine system. We are going to study in detail in this lesson. And you also have understood about the neuron. Okay, so you all have understood about the functions of the neuron and how to draw the neuron and the different parts and their functions as well. If you find this video is useful, kindly like this video and share with your friends. And if you're not subscribed to my channel, kindly subscribe to my channel. That's all for this session. I'm signing off. Thank you.